our Lord, the Holy Spirit, in this place, of course, the presence of Him. So may I call on Sister Adita Charito Toledo to lead the praise and worship. Yeah! Open your prayer, Sister Charito and staff, Pimento. Okay, so I'm sure everybody is here now. All of the bridesmaids are there, ready at the back. Good job. Okay. So may I request our bridesmaid to go back again, because we are going to start another entrance for you. Greetings to everyone, and once again, I am welcoming all the families, friends, and loved ones who are here today. So once again, first of all, we thank God that He is here today with us and celebrate His goodness and faithfulness to the life of our dear celebrant as we shower her with your love, blessings, and wishes. Please kindly stand up, and we are going to start again.
Again?
Yes.
Dry run.
Okay, may I have the sounds, please? Okay, this will gonna be the entrance. Let us all welcome the entrance of our bride to be, her beautiful bridesmaid. Where are you?
Candle.
Sorry.
May candle.
Ngayon, ang candidate represent tatlong tao. Una, yung pinakamalaki, which is the biggest one, ito si Peter. Kaya pag ano, ito siya yung magiging life mo, babae mo. Then, kayo itong dalawang mag-asawa. Ngayon, kayong dalawang mag-asawa, kung kayo na may life kayo, minsan, yan, diba? Isa ko na kayo, ha? Malala ko na yun. So nakita nyo, may tatlo siyang ilaw. Now, ito si Jesus, ito si God, ito yung dalawang mag-asawa. So mag-asawa, kailangan ng ilaw. Kasi pag may dilim, anong nakikita nyo? Wala, di ba? Wala kang makita sa dilim, kaya kailangan ng liwanag. So pag aasawa, kailangan meron kang gabay, meron kang ilaw. In order to see yung mga bagay-bagay na dapat natin makita sa pag-asawa. Kasi mag-asawa, hindi ba? Ngayon, halimbawa, kayong dalawa kayo, napunji yung isa. Eh, nawala ng ilaw. Yung parang sa mag-asawa, yung parang wala na, give up na. Ngayon, yung parang nagda-down siya. Ngayon, huwag siya pupunta sa nanay, huwag siya pupunta sa ano, pupunta siya sa asawa o kaya sa doon. Okay?
This bell symbolizes the symbolic reference of virginity or youth of the bride. Then either the father lifts the veil, presenting the bride to be to her groom, or groom lifts the veil to symbolically consummate the marriage. This veil also symbolizes to join them together and to lay a veil over them to plug them together. And it is also a symbol of the faithful love to each other. Through the passing of the years, let the veil remind you guys that you belong to each other and to no one else. And this veil pin on the groom's right shoulder and will drape on the veil over bride's head and pin it on the left side of her veil.
Yes, thank you, Sister Ari. Okay, next, may I call on?
I bring here. Symbolize the endless love of the couple, and it's supposed to symbolize their intimate bond together as one. And they will be usually held. This is tied. It goes on top of the head of the woman of the bride, and then the other side goes on the shoulder of the groom. So what it means is that the wife should submit to her husband, and her husband is always on top of her, and that means that whatever the decisions that the husband makes, as long as it's by God's will, and it's good and pleasing to God, then she should follow no matter what. And on the groom, what it means that it's on his shoulder is that that responsibility to lead another soul to God, and to lead another soul closer to him, and so that they will succeed in life. That's the biggest responsibility of all, and that's all I'm showing. So that's where you guys will be tied in on court.
Praise the Lord. It's all surprising to me. In the marriage, hindi po nawawala ang treasure or bone. Because the treasure symbolizes the prosperity of the newlywed. And as we know, she's here in Canada. Galing po siya ng Pilipinas, yung magiging sister niya. Ang sabi ko pala, So whatever treasure that you're gonna make, you have to join. And whatever decision that it involves money, kailangan mo pag-usapan. Because a lot of marriages, one of the reason why they are becoming separated is because of money. And before, you used to go to the mall, buy yourself to a shop. Pag-isipan mo muna kung anong bibilin mo at isasangunin mo sa iyong hindi mahal na asawa. So, ganun po yun. At hindi po tayo bilang mag-asawa, we just need to be yung malabo. Yung thank you.
Stop it!
Thank you. So, I'm pretty sure actually it is always provided because of your strength. Like sabi na sa Deuteronomy that God has the power to give you to make you a woman. So, sabuni lahat. Okay? God bless you. Pwede nyo rin, yung mga wrap natin. Yeah.
Why is the husband? There are lots of challenges, troubles that you will get when you start, or if you're there already. But when you have God with you, and surely you will overcome all the troubles. And as he said, in a union, in a marriage, it's a triangle. There's one on the left, and there's one on the right, and there's one on the right. So. In a marriage, always God put in the center, so that whatever you come, whatever the circumstances will come on your way, you will overcome it because God is with you. And be sure that this Bible will be.
What is always used symbol for wedding and a ring? So as we know, ring is circular in shape because it symbolizes eternity or forever, never ending, no ending. So there's forever. Even in the Bible it says, "What God has joined, let no man separate." So even though in our community, in the world we live in, annulment or divorce is legal, but in the sight of God, He wants it to be permanent. He wants it to be continuing forever. So that's what God will for marriage. And also, normally they use gold because it's a pure mineral. So let the love be pure. Let the love be pure. Also, a ring symbol of commitment or devotion.
Okay, Jenner, to make a simple message, or that we just do.
Everybody's
afraid. Well, I wish Grace many, 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 many years of happiness. Grace came into our life 4 years ago when you just came from the Philippines, and she's been magnificent. And she helped me raise my beautiful daughter, and forever I'm indebted, and I wish you all the best.
Please hit the cannon. Yes, to give another message to. Yes, and she is the employer of her sister, Maricar.
Bueno.
sister says to pray for the food. Going to throw the banquet bouquet. I'm sorry. Please, all the single. I am a single. Yes, I'm a single. Come on, singles here, please. All the singles. Can you? Are you single too? Come with me. Okay. All the singles, please. Come on. Where are you? Go there. How many are you? 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you single too? Of course I'm a single too. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Not yet. Okay, are you ready? Sige na nga, wag na ako dyan. Kayo na lang. Okay, ready. Are you ready? Guess it. Okay. Nakita nyo. Okay, are you ready? Get that! Huh?
Okay, which one is at the door?
Okay, are you ready? Get that! Go! Teka lang, isa minute. Okay, get that! Go! Are you ready?
Okay.
Ready? Get set? Go! Ate Chat, you're out of the way. Once again, congratulations! Picture now, picture. Okay, thank you once again to everyone, and may I call on all the volunteers who are going to help us to claim here. Thank you.